moment when you receive sad news that the person you've been sharing mornings is not going to be with you for the next couple of days. Yes, I'm talking about people in relationships. I'm talking about workmates and anyone that can relate to that. A very good morning to you. It's a beautiful Thursday morning. Twisting your mind is all I'm doing right about now. Taking you back into the days. It is the TBT version of course, Thursday. And even today, we shall be throwing back to some of those memories that we hold dear to our very own selves. You too can feel free to share those memories. All you need to do is head over to our social media pages, Urban Television, that is for Facebook and Twitter. It is at Urban TV Uganda. It is the 14th of November 2019, and my name is Derek Ainedash, and a very good morning to you who's just joining in for the next 2 hours of infotainment. In our starting news, we shall be having a bit of a reminder as far as the Butcherman is concerned. Some of you have decided to, you know, forget about him, focusing on Catherine Kusasira. Yes, but this man also has the same powers, or might be having the same powers after he has been verified by the Ministry of Public Service. And also away from that, we shall be taking you to the Rwenzururu Kingdom, all those ends of Kabarore side. What is happening as far as the UPDF is concerned? Rwenzori areas will be giving you some information coming in from that side. And then, of course, later on, we get into some shout-outs. And, of course, the love letter, which involves another mystery of a man who could have traveled miles. And when he got to Kampala, he said, I'm not going back. Women here are what I want. And a woman is crying, saying that my husband got another wife in Kampala. What happened? What is wrong with Kampala women? All that and much more will be coming in. And of course, later on, we'll be getting into some sports news. We could be giving you an update coming in from Arsene Wenger. He has a new role, or a new position, as far as the international footballer is concerned. We'll be getting into that a little bit later on. But for now, Tina Pierce and Willis ready to throw their throwback memories with me. Good morning to you guys.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
I got confused. Mm. I was wondering, is this my cup? Is that my cup? Is this my
just
cup?
Just smell them.
So
smell them.
I don't know what she's trying to insinuate here.
Continue.
Why would you smell? It's etiquette. You can't smell someone's cup.
I smell them.
Just smell. Uh-huh. Tell which one is yours.
How?
So when you smell.
By the different scents.
So mine smells how?
I don't know how yours smells or how his smells, but I definitely smell alike.
So do you want to smell?
Yes.
Okay.
Ateba na itembera ne kabole. Na ina echiduka no bamuteredde mu. Macha.
Echiduka mo chiwuniza mu chai.
No shege na kubera lito.
This morning, I actually, at first, I used to find that meme
disturbing. Then I understood it. Remember back in I know you don't know that because I'm way older, but Sengas used to give women advice, like when they were getting married, they're like, baze bwakoma weka nga ayagala kuyomba mwana wange koloti, just put water in your mouth and don't swallow it until he's done complaining.
So kabaka kuyamba chako,
it helps you not to talk back.
Because
there's water in your mouth, so it's kept wild.
I mean, you have to be very sad
for you to do that.
You have to be very sad for you to drink your water, to drink water and mind your own business.
I am telling you, Sima, whatever you've been doing to us on Twitter, madam.
Oh, mind your business. These people out here is thirsty. We need to hydrate. That's the honest truth.
Let me tell you, Willis, there is no way you're going to sit down, drink water, mind your business when you have some common in your pocket. It is impossible.
You have to mind other people's business.
When
you have some common in your pocket, I'm telling you, even the taste of water changes.
So you will go out and look for more, which means you're going to mind other people's business.
But when you don't have money, you're drinking water, you're minding your business.
You're just there.
You are sad.
Unemployment.
You can't drink water and mind your business.
But you can. Drink cucumber water. Okay, and mind
in deeper versions of it, yes.
Metaphorically
speaking. People
also
mind their own business. Mm. But drinking water and mind your business, you'll be fired. If you're not minding your boss's business, you'll be fired.
Because it's not your business, it's his business.
So if you're employed, you can't mind your business only. I'll drink water and mind my business. How? your boss,
your supervisor.
If you're a child, you have to mind your father's business.
Your mother's business, yeah, your sibling's business. It's a business thing. But in other news, let's sip tea.
But in other news, you need to drink water at the end of the day. You need to keep yourself healthy and keep yourself, you know, hydrated enough. And, you know, yeah, you keep yourself okay. But in other news, talking about throwback. Never down, Kaloza, Kechido. Nakata the next status.
Oh!
And you are still single. Madam. Ladies and gentlemen, twina meeting kuuma.
Lero.
Ya lero bayancha.
Ya lero. Tumwena.
Deni, ya bajita batya. Okwe gata in English bakuita batya.
Okwe gata.
Mingo.
Mingo. Mingo kena kubeira wencha.
Meet and mingo.
Mingo. Kati meeting ya lero ya kumanyigana. Tuma okay. Oh, Bridjo Josephine uli single. Uli wasenika manyo. Okay. Tugene wawili sulisi Bridjo uli single. Uli abuza bantu. Kwa gambo wanga walaba kwa esezo mto. You remember esezo mto.
Look at Josephine at the back of the camera flashing her wedding rings. Like.
Sika mba Josephine kamera person. Maja msatero kula wa shenyo. Like Facebook. Anzo kuleza soo gela kumkazi uwe. Nenda sebo. Tuwagela kudozefi ino mlarinya lizebuzi.
Mwema na Uganda mwaga dokole vipu.
Chima
chukwe. Mkoze simanya vichi, nsenene
shwa vichi.
I saw Mr. Chiwanda. Mkoze
mkatinawa mkoze chivulu.
Chivulu checho.
Now what are they going to do at the nsenene festival? Like there's only so many ways you can make nsenene. There's only so many ways.
But there are many.
That's well, there are many ways.
Listen.
Nsenene
broiled. Broiled. Nsenene Rolex. Nsenene pizza. The fried one.
The roasted one.
The majina nsenene?
No, nsenene. Then maji matini. Then chapati.
Still maji.
Still maji nsenene.
Nenda maji matini.
Anyo kudu kano kugeno kubawa.
Nzikuru will be your right hand man.
Let me tell you, there are such festivals. Me not making sure you have places of convenience or by inconvenience. Whatever you want to call it. Ngabunji budi yao. Kubanga chigendo kube rani Muganda.
But you see what bothers me about this whole thing? It actually doesn't bother me. For me, it's irony. You know how Ugandans sit on social media and they're like, oh my goodness, the youth, we're suffering, we're unemployed, there's no jobs, the government don't care about us. But I remember that week this year, the Nyege Nyege week. There was a chivulu
memories.
For 5 days of that week. Each chivulu got attendees.
Yeah, but do you know how many landlords test out tenants?
Very many. Very many. That one we expected because it was between Nyege Nyege or Te Orient, you know?
Orient, yes.
But the thing though for me is, you can afford to party on a daily, and the biggest number of people going to party are the youth. You jump from this one to this one to this one. Then after that, you sit and say, government took fuck.
No,
and,
and
literally, they are the same
and
person.
And they do not, kid by the way, they ball.
They are the same person.
No, listen, they ball on a
we
whole other level.
We have a vivid example of DJ Cream. By who pours water in a gun.
You see, when we're talking about partying, let us not mix partying, no kusera.
No, but that's...
Bila mitumianja ulo. Umsaja ya abasira. Fawala tuwela kupate business.
Tuwela kupate. Na ugele mkole chikulu chamwe.
Tuwela kule chikulu.
Abalaba esezo mto.
Ataba alaba Drake Sekeba, esezo mto, Charles Oimuke.
Bacha aliyo wababa nava.
Olio mlala yali akola African Express yali ani.
Go ndio no.
Dennis nga ino mto webuti. Colin. Mujukira Colin, the first guy who did Jamajen. Basically, buobanga wakula olaba WBS. Cats never
know. Sunset Beach.
Sunset Beach. Cats never know. Akabaga ndozo ulit. Kakuuma.
Aneda timutuwe yubako. Chwagala chwaule bajitaba cha generations. Efe tuli mitie mito. Na yese zana niwe yali yenka. Na yena gaba mtumutu.
Mtumutu.
Atana
abalaba Inspector Derek na boba ino falling under that category.
Teka cha fao. Tukena mene meeting ya fenge did under ni.
Abalaba
Inspector Derek.
Yo meeting yeri kwe NSSA. Uwela na yonga bofuna retirement package.
Ayari.
Ngoge na ngotu vida.
We thank you for your service. Thank you very much.
Ernest Bazanye.
Hey! Timothy Bukumune.
Hey.
Russ, yes. Then that guy, what's his name? Herbert something. The guy who, Harry Sagara, rather.
Yes.
Bebe Jemiaka. Man, Ernest Bazanye. But I used to read all his columns from the very first one, and he is still here.
But if you used to read old folks and you're still single.
Thank you.
There's also a problem.
I read the old folks.
There's also a problem.
And you are? I am. Josephine, mind your camera.
Baba watula koku kameme. Eh. Akataka singo vude kusomero.
Sentenga wazidibe.
Meeting ezezomuto ya kumanyigana bwetumala okumanyiganya result esembayo kwelya agenda kwegamba agenda ebera kiya
bamusavinga
neti it is going to be a rare picture of food carrying its own plate.
Next single kuluma is if you were in an era where TV was switched on at 6
at 10
yeah.
And you're still broke.
Air bump.
Singleness.
Air bump. Air bump.
If you're single.
I felt that to the core. Yeah. Like my broke. Spine just went like.
Kablaza.
To venom throwbacks.
It
was too deep.
Look at those days when you used to bring friends who have dreads at home about Gamba. Thank you for showing Vibs our TV. But our parents!
What
you are
wrong?
Such an icon.
Our parents are the official, like for me, they are the poster child for we have trust issues. Like, if you notice growing up, your parents just had major trust issues.
Even with you, their child. You couldn't sit in the chair.
Because you'd sit in the chair and then she goes and looks at you. Like, she finds you just sitting there and she's like,
have you been?
Okay. Like, I am sitting.
Like, sitting. What can't you see?
What is that spoon doing in the sink?
Thank you. Like, they just had major trust issues. Then when you just walk out of the house to probably go and do something again, she finds you walking. And she's like, wow. Nsasula amazzi to zero. Nemkoma okuva ku somero wiki emu. Yatuoze sama moto kaga neighborhood. We go na.
Gagamba oluguru, when you come back from school, go and shower. 5 minutes later, onaba
bichi. Tomara.
Trust issues, just ma. Hi.
Throwback memories, of course, are what we're getting into right about now. And remember, you can always share with us what are some of those memories that you can never let go of your childhood. That is why we call it Throwback Thursday, the version of Urban Today. Now, away from that, of course, we want to have a quick reminder that Butcherman is also still making headlines as far as his new role is concerned. This was given to him, of course, by His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. He is going to be acting as a senior presidential advisor on ghetto issues. We all know that this man had disappeared and was completely off the scene, but not until that fateful day when President Yoweri Museveni said, you know what, it's about that time, I need to be part of the ghetto, and that is the man right there. And we believe that as soon as, you know, the Ministry of Public Service does get to verify him and Catherine Kusasira, they'll become civil servants, and henceforth, they'll be able to give out reports on their duties. But a very interesting, thing with that picture right there is the wife.
She's gorgeous.
She's gorgeous. She's everything. Apparently, rumor has it that she has a master's, but I am yet to find out master's in what.
It's a master's degree.
Of what?
Some of us are lingering around jobs with the diplomas.
Mona in a master's.
She's in the ghetto. She has taken the master's to the ghetto.
Together.
But you know, for me, Butcherman's story goes to say that no matter what you do in life,
if it's meant for you, it's meant for you. Your destiny is your destiny. How he fell out with Bobby Wine, and then he just went. Then the next time he surfaced, he was at a police station answering a case for stealing a hen, a chicken. Like, but, clack, clack, clack.
But the woman stuck with him. Tiamuleka.
She has stuck with him through it all. And
yeah, does it cut? We didn't know.
Yeah, but they were. Because we have another similar thing.
They have beautiful kids.
Why is it neighbor no genda yomboyo mchara wa?
Wait.
It only never put the presidential advice.
No, I'm behind.
No, I'm a child. I'm going, no. Vichy.
No, sorry, I know. So, where I am, yeah, I never wanted to be money.
But I think right now is the time, you know, where she should be taking advantage of this and using
get the most out of it to get herself and her babies and her man.
Because you don't know how long it's going to last.
It's not, we know how long it's going to last. 2020, that's it. I'm looking at everyone who is making plans. I need for all of you to understand. 2020, elections are music.
2021, around January 2021.
Kati 2020 is where it starts and ends. Mm. Because by 2021, tugenda kumanya wetuli.
Ngechemanyi by January 2020, next year, tugenda kubanga to shift in zetuli mubintu bidala nyo. Because already the, you know, the NRM top dogs are already now meeting the president and saying, Chichi,
what can we do?
How do you bring us these people? And bring them
the internal fights, yeah, the internal fights have been real. Catherine has been beating heads with the head leaders of the NRM youth in Kampala region. That's Uhuru, Godfrey Nyakana, and those are top dogs who feel they have given for the party. But
so what's your full name?
Now even if you are for a presidential advisor, I don't know how to combine from Zama Jen. Someone needs to come and explain to us what's going on.
No, I wanted us to actually do a feature where we look for someone from the UPDF, a spokesperson, to Mubuze. So explain it to us. Just
maybe when you become a presidential advisor,
you become
they give you a course.
A course to do what?
In the army, you become a constable.
Because you're constable.
You're a constable.
Yeah, she's just been moving. She's street smart.
Yes. I mean, with in the lights of
Sige Mageza Maganda,
you have the station Mayanjas, you have all these people, but you know, out of all those men.
Wait, Ngoma. You look at the button, and you're like, are you together? Did you come together?
Bluetooth.
That is why I fail to believe that the God I serve created that person.
Not the God I serve.
This is not God's image.
God's plan.
Getting into some sad news, of course, making headlines, UPDF deploys a special force in the Rwenzori region. Now, the details coming in is that the Uganda People's Defense Forces have deployed a special force in the Rwenzori region. According to the Chief of Defense Forces, General David Muhozi, the fully fledged division will have its headquarters at Mohoti Barracks in Kabarore District. Muhozi said its reach will stretch from Katunguru in Kasese District, Mubende and Chegwegwa Districts. A statement issued by UPDF on Wednesday noted that a newly deployed mountain division will help the region combat threats from pockets of terror groups such as Allied Democratic Forces. The region has been under the threat of ADF, now located in the eastern DRC. UPDF officials noted the division will be commanded by Brigadier Moses Kwekezirika. That is, of course, the former commander of the 3rd Infantry Division. ADF.
What else do we have?
Protect Uganda.
Like, you know, there's some stories that I personally cannot deal with when it comes to national security. Because, I mean, you know what? What is our next shout out?
Because you sent again.
No, because it goes back to what he says. Mm. Uganda is just a country that only does things for the moment. Like, until they feel the threat is there, is when they will do it. Actually, after the threat has come to them, they're like, eh, we need to protect this area. I'm like, you're supposed to know the loopholes in your security.
Uganda kugamba, tujukira kubuka nga tumaze kwekona.
The army, interestingly, has very good people who plan for the future. I think years ago is when a story broke that Uganda makes its own bullets. You know, so month, 1 year or 2 years ago, there's a story that Uganda has a factory that I think assembles these big military...
Yeah, the military cars,
military trucks. So I think that, you know, those guys plan. It's these other areas.
That have just manyang. Disaster preparedness.
Disaster preparedness.
I knew.
I think for them...
Who is the Minister of Disaster Preparedness, by the way? Because I think we need to... Wait. We need to add him onto that monthly reminder.
Let me ask on Twitter. By the end of the show, we
like,
shall
seriously,
know.
Seriously, you remember that thing where people are like, just a friendly reminder. Edward Second is still the VP.
It's usually a monthly reminder.
A monthly reminder. Kakati, we need a monthly reminder of who is our Minister for Disaster Preparedness. I mean, Lukodo's name is louder than this guy.
Lukodo is dealing with a very
sensitive
issue. Kind of issue. My friend, pornography is not a joke.
Disaster is a joke.
Disaster is a joke now. But anyway, let's move away from that and get into some shout outs right about now. Now, apparently, my shout outs are going into the 80 officers who have deserted police training school. Now, police have ordered the arrest of 91 officers on site on allegations of deserting the force. At least 80 of the officers that are said to have deserted were recently transferred to police training school, Kabarie, in Masinde district as instructors. Now, a police statement dated November 11th, sent by the Assistant Commissioner of Police, Mr. Emmanuel Muhaire, states the following personnel who were reported as, of course, absent without leave by various units are hereby declared deserters. If seen, they should be arrested, and respective unit commanders should inform police headquarters for collection. Among the deserters are 25 sergeants, 37 corporals, and 28 police constables. There is one thing to serve and protect your nation. I know 2K training in Uganda.
Yo, Kankubulide, my buddy was one of these unemployed youth. Police. I am sure.
Am I the yardstick of being short?
Hello? Mwanza chichi? Mama tineno bakube mingo. Mwana yako maunga taina nakozi. Mgongo kunaka kujide nkwa gulo. Mugamba jina gamba buosango ofisa mukasana anga munyivu na kugamba. Oh, go, I'll put you in. He keeps having flashbacks of what happened in Masindi.
But on a daily. Best training you can ever have in police or the army, and you know you succeed properly and get your ranks and start serving, is the training you get when they catch you after you've deserted. That is the best training you will get as an
after
officer.
After you have deserted and then
they get you back.
If you want to succeed and be a disciplined officer,
desert and come back.
Migo jika wa.
Migo.
Migo. Psychological torture. Mchaja
hizo kugama kwata batu niwe kuwe. Ajoka ame.
Buta hiwe.
Niwe kwa naga angate wewe kuwa nyo. Obanku kuwe.
Naga manenda sewa kaneko.
There's a video, a very interesting video of, it was I think training somewhere. And these were very young guys who were under training in the army. Ne wabagamba kwe kuwe ngolo. Wawa kalaba.
Sakala.
Nga mwe kuwe ngolo.
Dinda ko. Nga mwe mirira mwe.
Mwe mirira cross. No kuwa. Nga tu.
For how long?
Nga hizo kugama 2 hours. Katika tandecha liwa gaine na siku kubira dara. Ate jukira. They shave you bald.
Ngo kuba mu sport em.
Gwa sala o gwa
ko. Obo kuba ku matu obo kuba ku nkona.
Na yengo lwe bi nya bicha ali awo. Engo lwe muzungu bajita.
Na ina mwanda wange. I have a brother.
Kaso ako demo chivuzi cha.
Ndo zali kudda
kubuza.
Ndo zali kudda.
Engo lwe muzungu.
Enoko.
Bajita. Ama finger.
What?
Anti. finger, hammer. Hammer finger, see Ngolo.
Boba manye Ngolo Muzungu. Please get our Facebook page or even our Twitter and tell us what is Ngolo Muzungu. Tuyambe.
For real, what's Ngolo
Muzungu? Two officers were undergoing training, and you know, the task they were set up to do was
to hammer finger each other
and hammer finger each other in the head. Or finger hammer each other. Or carry
like, they were finger hammering each
Ngolo,
other.
In English, translate.
Finger hammer.
Just tweet us at Aine Dasha, at Willis Dale, and Tina Fierce 1.
I can't even.
I have a brother who actually deserted from the police training. He was actually a policeman in training and deserted. Again, I'm charity quickly. Waja Jawi. Nevamufuna. Right now, he's a disciplined, clean officer of the Uganda People's Police. Uganda Police.
Not for us.
Disciplined.
As in.
Abi Ali Station, Chinagana Muzeko.
Anyway, David, we are Uganda. I'm sending shout outs to the Uganda Air Cargo Corporation that is nursing an 8 billion loss.
Okay.
Now, Uganda Air Cargo Corporation has asked the parliament to support an 8 billion bailout from losses registered in 2014. Now, the corporation is the business airline operated by the Ministry of Defense, incorporated by an Act of Parliament in 1994. The carrier operates scheduled and charter cargo and passenger services from its main base at Entebbe International Airport, which destinations limited to East Africa and Central Africa. Now, Captain John Atakat, the chairperson of the board of the air cargo, while appearing before the Defense and Internal Affairs Committee of Parliament yesterday, said the airline registered the loss during a shutdown between 2014 and 2016 when its operator certificate was revoked by the International Aviation Organization. However, 3 years since it resumed its operations, the airline is limping with the loss, yet two of its aircraft remain grounded due to cracks on the center wing box. There's a song that just went through my mind. I think it was done by
one
the Myth.
Yellow duck.
No.
Swimming. I thought you were going to Uganda Airlines. Swim, swim, swim.
No, it's
Uganda
not swimming, Air swimming. I'm so UG.
Two people I'm going to shout out to this morning. One is a good story, the other is unfortunately a sad story. But for the good side of the story, Simanyo wa mwalimu tuseko Mutsironko district. Mutsironko district. It's one of the new districts actually. Not new. Ne walinga tuchalimu, should we create new districts or not? So Mutsironko district is one of those districts. Now Mutsironko district, let me not go political. But let me just go shout out to the person I want to shout out to. This is a very hardworking lady who I know personally, and today morning yantu se kunanga anti, by the way, njaga kwe simba kuwa MP.
Esirongo.
Nemuga na iguani akumani.
Naga kusaga.
Nanda gachati inga alimu grupu ze Sironko na tide. Nga siroza na kuzanti Sironko waliyo network.
Yano.
Naejari. Ivu kajeji. Kayeji, Eve Kayeji.
We're happy for you. Go do you.
I did know, but I don't know where we are headed as people. Because me now I have like four people around me that
who are going to be parliamentarians. And that's what I kept telling you people.
I don't know what's happening.
Be careful the people we give the power to, because at the end of the day, it's us to suffer repercussions. So among those four, how many do you think are worth the Ugandan?
I think all of them, because I've known these people, you know, personally, at a personal level. They've been that kind of person who, you know, is very strict. There are people who are going by
then the yours pass. Me, I know
but
four.
But politics changes you.
I know four too. But I know for a fact, if I was, they are my buddies, but if I was to stand with their voters, I would be like Temumua.
If Kajai Tumide Konyo this morning, I give
after
it to
2021
you.
Elections, 2026.
Zambar.
Now Oga Kwesimba.
MP.
At that time, I think we might have reduced the number of MPs. And some places like Mbarara don't need an MP.
I think so.
You cannot have over 20 ministers. Then you have the leaders of opposition. Then
like
you have everyone. You don't need an MP.
You see, even the Bible says, Aoine nuwariyonjere wako. You cannot just pick a place where they do not have anything and you give them everything. You have to pick someone who has something and you give them everything.
I'd like for you to understand that I am not a 26
youth MP. I need Derek. Youth MP.
On a sad note, though, I'd like to shout out to the family of a man who died in Chigo prison. And it's a very sad story there. The family of 41-year-old Robert Chituka and Namulanda along Entebbe Road were left puzzled after they later was turned home in a coffin just a month after his imprisonment in Kigo prison. According to Olive Nakate, a widow to the deceased, Chituka had was detained on October 16th over land-related matters. Court had ordered him to refund 8.8 million or be imprisoned for 3 years, and that's according to Nakate. And she said, I had finished all the paperwork to secure a loan for his release when I got contacted by prison warders that said my husband had died of heart attack and told me to pick the body from Mulago Hospital. Gabriel Makwa, a friend of the deceased, intimated that he last visited Kituka weeks ago, but the latter never complained of any illnesses while he was in prison.
That's very sad. Are
we,
right there.
Let me ask, are we trying to
say there's
foul play somewhere?
I don't know.
Does it look like that?
It's possible, because if someone says I visited the guy and the guy said he was fine. Okay. But again, you have to also understand that a heart attack is a heart attack.
Exactly.
It can come to you if
at any time.
Yeah.
You could be stressed and thinking, and boom, you get a heart attack and die. So it's a very sad story there.
It is.
Yes, may his soul rest in eternal peace. But moving away from that, we want to pay some bills up. And of course, when we do get back, Urban Today still continues. And we shall be getting straight into our press digest.